What do they call that when you daydream at night?
I wouldn't know. I haven't done that in a long, long time.
Saw her. Luke, I saw the house where my daughter grew up, and I saw the woman who raised her.
Must have been difficult for you.
Well, you know, if you mean, did it hurt? Yeah. But we didn't hate each other. I mean, I think I was a bit of a shock to Virginia Benson. I think maybe she'd fantasized I was a wayward debutante or something.
Oh, right. She met me. She must have figured you were a blue blood.
Well, I don't know what either one of us thought, but gosh, in a way, we kind of did understand one another. And then, once we started spilling our feelings about Caroline, neither one of us could stop.
Well, then that's good, isn't it? You said what needed to be said.
Yeah, but the point is, it all needs to be said to my little girl.
Hold it, Barbara. Your little girl ain't a baby anymore, okay? She's a 22-year-old woman. Presumably with a life.
Yeah, but what kind of life? That's what I'm afraid of. And so is Virginia. But neither one of us could bring ourselves to say that.
You start that paranoia, you're in for nothing but pain.
Well, maybe so. But the only way my pain is ever going to go away is to make sure that my daughter's all right. Luke, I'm begging you, please. This time you've got to find her for me. You up here? I'm sorry.
What do you mean, make me sad? I love it that you want to share this place with me.
Good. You're honestly the only person that I would. Why was it so easy to share with you? To tell you everything?
Could we not start speaking in the past tense just yet?
Right. I'm sorry. We still have a couple more hours, at least.
Right. And this is not what we meant to do. We were supposed to come up here and have a simple time. Pretend that we had not a care in the world and it was never going to end.
That's right.
So, naturally, we should bring out food.
Yes.
I would think. Seems.
All right.
And wine.
Wine,
I believe.
Good.
That is assuming I brought the corkscrew, and I did, because no neurosurgeon ever goes without a good corkscrew.
You know what? This is the same kind as that night at your house. Do you remember when I made dinner for you?
No.
Oh, illegal territory.
What is? That I kissed you?
No, that is the night that I realized how much I cared about you.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
How's that look?
It's cute.
Well, me too.
Really?
Yeah, I tried to reason myself out of it for a long time, but couldn't do anything about it. Didn't work out, did it?
No. But we are going to have to make it work from now on.
Yes, we are.
Still, I can't help wondering, you know, what it would have been like if we had met in a different place, if you hadn't been married.
Mm-hmm.
There I go. There I go with the what ifs again.
So that's the kind of daydreams that you have?
Sometimes. I try not to get into it, though. It hurts.
Yeah, like hell. Actually.
I thought you didn't dream.
Fitfully. Now and then. So what else do you dream about when you come up here?
You know, the usual girlish stuff. Like winning the lottery.
That's girlish.
You see, I'm basically a very practical person. So even in my daydreams, I have to know how things are financed. I mean it. It's true. Like, I can't dream about having a red convertible unless I know how I'm going to make the payments.
You're crazy.
Do you think? Do you think I'm awful?
No, you're a touch over-responsible, but that's you.
Yeah. I once had this daydream, you know, that I was going to go to France. And I was going to drive from Paris to Italy. But then I heard this little voice inside my head say, you can't do that, dummy. You don't have a passport. And I don't even know how to drive.
That's simple. Take your birth certificate down to the passport office. And as for driving, I teach you.
That would be fun.
I can't get this final. I'm not used to one with cork. Usually they have a screw top that says some funny name on it.
Guess this is it.
Yeah.
Thank you for today. I mean, that is something I will always have.
We both will.
Tony, you know, I think that we're going to have to establish some ground rules, you know, if we're going to manage at the hospital.
Okay. So tell me. Yes, sir?
Stop it. I think we should keep our distance, you know. Nod hello and not so cold that people notice, but not really friendly either.
It's not going to be easy.
No. Oh, that's quite a load, considering everything. But, you know, I think it can't be the way that it was before I was close to you. You know, before you helped me. Mm-hmm. I made love to me. Mm-hmm. How am I gonna do that? How am I gonna look at you and not remember what that was like? How special you made me feel.
Hey, you are special. You don't forget that, okay?
I won't forget anything, okay?
Okay. You know, I can't do this.
Oh.
Yeah, I should do a lot of things.
Yeah, but not this. Not anymore, Tony. I really do understand that.
What?
Don't look at me, okay? I'll be fine. Just go home. Go back to your family, okay? Be happy. And thank you for a wonderful day.
Thank you.